M. Night Shyamalan's 19-year buildup Glass has finally hit this weekend. Does it live up to the hype, or does it just break down like Glass and it's just disappointing? What's going on, guys? Ryan O'Toole back here again, giving you guys another review. Today I'm going to be reviewing one of my most anticipated films this year, my third most, and it is M. Night Shyamalan's Glass, the third film in his Unbreakable Split trilogy, and directed by M. Night Shyamalan and written by him, starring James McAvoy, Bruce Willis, Samuel L. Jackson, Anya Taylor-Joy, and Spencer Treat Clark. Now, before I talk about Glass, guys, this review is going to be spoiler-free. This is a huge movie, and I know a lot of you have not seen Glass yet, and I want to be respectful to those who haven't seen it yet, so if you have seen it, do not post spoilers down below, and this review is going to be spoiler-free, so you are safe here. In this film, we follow the three main characters from Unbreakable and Split. James McAvoy as the Horde, or Kevin, and since his time in Split, he has been dealing with all these personalities himself, and he gets captured, and so does David Dunn, and he's trying to recover a lot after Unbreakable. And Elijah Price is stuck in the mental institution, and all three of these guys are stuck in the same mental institution. They're being monitored by this doctor, played by Sarah Paulson, who is telling them that they're not superheroes like they're saying they are, and they're keeping them locked up and trying to prevent other things from happening. And Elijah Price and, of course, Kevin in the film team up, and David Dunn as well has to be a hero. And this is the superhero film that M. Night Shyamalan's been wanting to make. Ever since the post-credit scene of Split, and the twist revealed that Split is in the same universe as Unbreakable. It's the Unbreakable sequel, and now Glass is the film that's going to bring both of these franchises together. And Shyamalan, he had a lot to do. I mean, he had a lot of hype to live up to, and I didn't want this movie to be disappointing, and many people wanted to as well. We wanted it to be amazing. So going into this movie, I was super excited. I was so pumped, finally ready to see this final conclusion and all these characters back and seeing them interact for the first time. Was Glass good? Was it okay? Was it bad? I can say Glass is a good movie. It is a really solid film. M. Night Shyamalan, his direction in this film is fantastic, and Glass had a lot of great aspects to it. But I gotta say, guys, I was a little let down with the final product of Glass. It is not a perfect movie, and it did kinda underwhelm me. Bruce Willis, Samuel L. Jackson, and James McAvoy, all three of these guys are fantastic with one another. Everything that they've been through since their films, especially David Dunn, Bruce Willis gives his best performance he's given since Looper. Yeah, he hasn't been in that many great movies, but here's David Dunn. I can see people having an issue with Bruce Willis's performance. David Dunn's been through a lot in his life. He has to try to convince people that he is a superhero, and he's had to deal with the aftermath of hearing Elijah Price being the main villain, and he has to be in hiding. He's a vigilante, and I thought Bruce Willis did a fantastic job in this movie. Elijah's been through a lot, being stuck in this mental institution. He's just this broken down character that you feel so bad for and you're sympathetic towards. And Elijah's such a fascinating character. Samuel L. Jackson's fantastic in this movie. I really like his costume as well. And Anya Taylor-Joy returns from Split. She's also fantastic. Spencer Treat Clark, David Dunn's son from Unbreakable, returns. He's great. The best performance in this film is James McAvoy. James McAvoy eats the whole entire screen time, every single moment he is on the screen. How has this guy not gotten an Oscar nom for this performance? How many personalities this guy has to juggle in this movie is absolutely insane. There's some brutal action sequences in this film. And Shyamalan, he does a great job with the action. And there's some great fight sequences with David Dunn and Kevin in this film that were pretty cool. The cinematography in those action scenes were pretty gruesome. And it's not clean. There is some bloody parts to it. The setting in this movie is very claustrophobic. If you don't like mental hospitals, then this whole entire movie pretty much takes place at this mental institution. I just really love the cinematography in the film. If feels totally realistic. All the color backgrounds look absolutely fascinating. Shyamalan knows what he's doing behind the camera. His direction is absolutely fascinating. You know, this is a story he's always wanted to tell. I mean, after Unbreakable come out, I mean, come on, that movie was absolutely fascinating. This is a world that I wanted to examine more. And when Split came out in 2017, it looked like something completely different from him, but seeing it's part of the Unbreakable universe, and I was just very interested to see what this film would be. And I thought Shyamalan, direction-wise, he pulled it off direction-wise. But this film is not perfect. It did disappoint me overall with how the film ended. I like Sarah Paulson as an actress. She's a very good actress, and she's been in some good comedies here and here, but I did not like her character in this movie at all. I thought her performance was very wooden, very stale. Her character was just paint by numbers. Nothing but exposition, and she's just there to move the plot forward. She really has no resonance to her, no rememberability. And with her character in some certain scenes, that just really made me shocked by, I didn't like this character at all. A lot of the camera shots in this movie are very up close. That really got on my nerves after a while. With Sarah Paulson in particular, there's a huge close-up of her face and James McAvoy, Bruce Willis. There's so many up-close camera shots that gets kind of cringeworthy and awkward. Okay, now let's talk about the thing that everyone is going to talk about. That's the ending. Or the final act. The final act was so disappointing. It just ended up being hollow, and it wasn't as good as the first two acts. The way the film ended, I was so let down. Overall, guys, Glass had a lot of great aspects to it. Shyamalan's direction, this movie is definitely worth seeing. It is a good movie, but not perfect. There's so many things I want to talk about, but it's spoilers, guys. Go see it for yourself. I can understand why this film has the low score it has on Rotten Tomatoes. That final act is going to be very divisive between a lot of people, and for me, it didn't work, in all honesty. On my rating scale, I'm going to give Glass a 3.5 out of 5 stars. I first thought of giving it a 3, but then I thought about the direction and the performances. 3.5 out of 5 stars is a good solid grade, but kind of disappointed in it. I wanted to be better. There you have it, guys. That was my spoiler-free review for Glass. Have you guys seen Glass yet, and what were your thoughts on it? Did you love it, think it was okay, or did you absolutely hate it? Let me know down below. Thank you guys, as always, for watching this review. And if you guys liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe today for more content. All my social media links are in the description down below. Click that notification bell on your way out, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!